Payson. Good evening, Payson. We're here live in Payson High School as we get ready for the first round of the Utah State 5A Boys Basketball Playoffs. I'm Matt Watkins.
And I'm Preston Carr, and right now we're about 2 minutes away from game time.
As Payson gets ready to battle Jordan. Payson, the three seed coming into the tournament, Jordan sitting at 30. Payson fresh off a win Friday in which they took a region beating Stansberry. Preston, what do you think Payson has to do to win here tonight?
Definitely from what I've seen from past Payson games, they really need to be aggressive with their defense and make sure just not give them any room, especially for three-pointers, because I feel like that's where a lot of the teams are able to get them from, is those threes. And as we stated in other games, Payson is undefeated at home, so we're hoping to keep that streak tonight as we go into this first round into the state tournament.
Yes, Payson undefeated at home, and for Jordan, I think they need to be able to take care of the ball. When Payson's got into that full court press, lots of teams turn the ball over, and Payson's able to grow their lead. Jordan, if they could, like you said, make threes and get transition buckets, Payson will be in trouble. Jordan severely the underdog here, as they are 5-13. They only have 5 wins on the season, so it should be an interesting matchup. We'll see how Jordan comes out tonight.
And we will come back to you guys when the game starts. St. Payson, and we're beginning to light up right now. Looks like we have number 42, Bridger Taylor for Payson, and number 31, Landon Sullivan, going for the jump ball at the beginning of this game.
As we get ready here for the jump ball to start the playoffs here in Payson. And
there it is.
Jordan wins it. And Will Green, their leading scorer, averaging 16 points per game. He's definitely going to need an all-night tonight if Jordan is to pull off the upset.
Number four, David Nagasso, passing over to number two.
Green misses that one, and rebound is controlled by Taylor.
And a pass by Isaac Wolf, and don't think his teammate Sada goes straight out of bounds.
Behind Robbins, and not a good pass there. Careless turnover there, and Payson's got to eliminate the nerves early, you know. You got to play with confidence, but you also got to realize that this Jordan team's going to show up. It's the playoffs. It's now or never.
Absolutely, especially with how important this game is. I mean, the next team will move on to the next bracket for the state team, but I would say get those mistakes out early if you're going to have them at all. Just you don't want them late game when it's really going to start hitting you hard.
Green, no good from three, and that's what we talked about before game. You needing to hit your threes, pace and not too great at three-point defense. And
Robbins passes over to Byes. He passes to Wolf.
Foul there.
On number four for Jordan, David Danovan Nagasa. That is, I've totally butchered that name and feel a little bad for that, but.
As Byes now will pass it in, or get the ball, sorry. Finds Robbins inside. Robbins averaging 11 points per game, the second leading scorer.
Pass it over to Gra, and then back to Robbins, over to Byes. Payson really moving the ball right now, but Jordan not wanting to give up any room for them to take any shots right now.
And this is where Payson has excelled, you know, continuing to pass the ball and with no shot clock, as Wolf is money there. And Payson takes the three-point lead.
Takes the first point of the night as well.
Good take there by Wolf, and Payson, when they're able to drive, is a great drive.
Then before the gas dump drives in.
Robbins with three of his own.
And a beautiful shot, nothing but net on that.
Payson got off hot early, let's see if they can continue that. And with this crowd definitely a factor here tonight, Jordan's gotta be able to eliminate the crowd noise.
Number 33 right now, really struggling to get rid of the ball.
Tight defense there by Taylor, and great job so far by the Lions defending. As that one is swatted by Robbins.
And Robbins passes over to Gra, who goes for the three, and he makes it.
Payson, a perfect 3-for-3 from three to start the night.
Right now, Jordan really needs to stop allowing those threes for Payson, or else they're going to walk all over them tonight.
So far, Payson's just been able to control the tempo, and Jordan has not been able to do anything on offense, as three is good. No.
Wide open shot there, but just misses it off the rim. Number 33, though, trying to drive in.
Almost stolen by Robbins, but it did go out of bounds. Good defense there by the Lions once again. So it will be Jordan's ball with about 5 minutes left in this first quarter. As a good putback there by Sullivan.
Robbins now taking the ball down. Looking over, Byes taking the ball. Very nice ball moving by Payson right now.
Payson's done it all year, and when they've been able to pass the ball on the perimeter, eventually someone gets open, and that's when they get the shot. Payson all year has been great sharing the ball.
And this team very just easily passing the ball, knowing where each other is at all times. Number 33, though, Gardner taking the ball.
As that one's good, and Jordan is on a nice 4-0 run. Nine-6 here for Payson as we are halfway through the first quarter of play. Inside now to Taylor, who...
Pass over to Dubois, who takes the three. Just misses it. There's the first miss of a three tonight for Payson.
Quickly now, and Will Green, who averages 16 in the game, has been off tonight so far. We'll see if he can...
Number 31, Sullivan trying to make that three, but is unable to.
That one's stolen, and Jordan is playing great defense.
By Wagner.
Jordan right now has tightened up on defense. They allowed three early threes, but since then have really shut down Payson.
I mean, you're seeing a lot more ball movement, I feel like, from that beginning of the game, and starting to really try to move the ball more. That Robbins takes the ball.
Robbins now will slow it down, find Taylor down low. The foul was before the shot, so we'll be out of Payson's ball. Great unselfish play there by Robbins. As Byes will pass it in for the Lions. Preston, through the first half of this first quarter, what have you seen here from Jordan?
Jordan really tightening up on their defense, trying to not let Payson get those threes. As you can see, they're really trying to not let them have those three opportunities, because that's what got Payson ahead. And they're really trying to move the ball a lot more when they're doing their offense, too.
As Robbins with his second swat of the game, he's been great so far on the defensive end.
And Robbins is definitely a player you want to look out for. I mean, Robbins is one of the best shooters for Payson, if not the best, as far as I'm aware. And he's a madman on offense and absolute beast when it comes to defense.
And
really what you want to look out for.
And Will Green there getting his first points of the game to put Jordan within one. They're on a 6-0 run here.
Payson hoping to break that streak with this possession right now.
Payson's turned the ball over the last couple of possessions, and they got to really take care of it here. Jordan, you can tell, is fighting, and Mitchell will call a timeout. So we're about three-fourths of the way here, way through this first quarter. Payson jumped, got up early fast, and now Jordan's starting to fight back.
Absolutely. I mean, Jordan all of a sudden is just taking the ball every single time, not even allowing Payson to get any shots off when they're over on defense, and is able to break through Payson's defense. And as you said, they're on a 6-point streak right now, and they're only one away from taking the lead or from tying it up.
And Jordan, they're a team with just 5 wins, right? Coming in, Payson, you know, you talk about it all week, how any team can win, but you still know in that feeling that you should win this game. Payson needs to step it up here.
And as the Jordan players, I'd be a little intimidated. I mean, Payson has an amazing win streak this season with only one or two losses. While Jordan, again, only has like those 5 wins.
Payson has yet to trail so far in this game. As Byes now trying to drive in.
Byes really moving the ball.
Payson's
going to double team.
Payson's tried to drive in all night, but so far it has not been open.
It's like I'm seeing a lot of double teams up from Jordan.
That one
just bounces off the rim. I thought it was going in about 3 or 4 times there.
Josh Cornell missing that shot. And Jordan with a chance to take the lead here.
22, Kent Dean passes over to number 2.
And what a defensive game this has been. With just 2 minutes left, we haven't even reached double digits. And 1. Jordan will take their first lead of the game.
Foul was on, I believe, number 24, Trey Bennett, for Payson.
Looks like that foul was on Josh Cornell. And shot is good. Cooper Swayze now checking in for Isaac Wolf.
Cooper Swayze, only a sophomore, but absolute madman on this court. Can't wait to see what he does for this team in this last 2 minutes of this quarter.
We'll see. They need a spark here on offense.
And there it is. Robbins drives in, tying up the game right there.
When you need points, get it to your playmaker. And that was a great design play there coming out. And tight defense here by the Lions. We'll see what the thought process is.
Not giving them a lot of room, and they try to drive in, and they're unable to do it.
There is a foul, however. So it looks like number 33. Camden will go to the line. He'll shoot two here and look to give Jordan back the lead. Big crowd here tonight for the first round of the playoffs.
Again, trying to just make one point to get that lead back up and maybe trying to get into Payson's head a little bit.
Both fall, so Jordan back with a two-point lead.
Wolf now driving down the ball. With Swayze passing to Robbins. Oh. Robbins not, just looked away right as Swayze tried to make that pass and just right over Robbins' head.
Good idea there, but poor execution. Payson, another turnover, which has really hurt them this game.
And Jordan really moving the ball right now. He's swatted by Cooper Swayze.
That's going to be a foul on Jordan. It looks like it's going to be a number 22, or is that on number 2?
I believe that was number 2. Green. Buys now driving down.
It's Green's first personal foul. And a good stop there by Payson. Down 2.
Payson moving the ball right now very nicely, just outside of that arc.
Yet to drive in, really. All but 2 of their points have been from beyond the arc, so definitely need to find a way to get open.
Wolf, though, drives in, though. Barely misses it, though.
And Jordan is able to get the rebound. I'm kind of surprised here from Payson we haven't seen the full court press. It seemed to work well for them all year long.
I mean, absolutely. I feel like they're being a little bit passive with their defense right now. I would say be aggressive, especially with how this team is kind of walking all over them. But Robbins passes over to Buys, who gets swatted.
Putback is good by Trey Bennett.
Bennett able to get the rebound and make that shot. And that, again, ties up the game. Buys takes the ball again.
And shot is no good, as we are tied here at the end of the first quarter. Preston, Jordan came storming back. What do you saw that they did there during that run?
I mean, they did start passing the ball a lot more and started putting a lot more pressure just beyond that arc on Payson. And Payson, I feel like, being a little bit too passive with their defense. They need to be more aggressive with that defense and really push on that. Jordan should not be walking over them with this score, but right now it's absolutely amazing just watching these two teams. Really good defense, only 13 points in the first quarter.
And they're announcing one of the state champion wrestlers we had here at Payson. We had 3 take state, and the team took 2nd overall. So great for that wrestling community.
Wrestling, one of the best sports at Payson. It was a big upset when we barely lost that, when we barely lost state, but you went and I was able to beat us there. Team's walking back on for the second half.
Second quarter will begin. Payson will get the ball.
Looks like Swayze will be passing in for Payson.
It looks like Green's going to try to guard Bryce here right from the start.
Green's passing over to Swayze, who then passes to Robbins, who almost loses the ball but is able to pick it up. But gets swatted.
That one went out of bounds, however. And we'll stay with Payson. Good defense, though, by Jordan, nearly forcing another turnover.
Robbins throwing the ball over to Taylor.
Robbins will have the ball.
Over to Swayze.
Misses that one.
But Taylor's able to get the rebound, and Robbins takes the shot. He makes it. Payson getting a lead since Jordan was able to pass them up.
Great job so far by Robbins here, finding open shots, and great rebound by Taylor.
Number 22, Dean trying to drive in is unable to. Robbins, though, driving down the court. He makes the layup. Payson up by four now.
And this is exactly what Payson needed, what you were talking about here during that break at the end of the first. Payson needed to be more aggressive, and they've answered that so far. Pullback is good by number 22, Dean.
Robbins now bringing the ball down for Payson.
As Byes has it now. Payson continuing to pass the ball, and I really like this by Payson.
I mean, that is something they've always been good at, is moving the ball. And Robbins just missing the three right there with the rebound by Jordan.
Green will bring it down.
Gagner going for the three. He makes it.
And Jordan goes back on top.
Up by one now. Payson driving down again. Swayze. Bridger Taylor takes a shot. He makes it.
Good shot there by Taylor. And good find there by Swayze.
Number 10 drives in. That's Staley. He's able to make it. Puts them up by one again.
Jordan is a very young team, and they're seniors right now, stepping up.
Robbins goes for the three, rolls out. Taylor goes for the two, is unable to make it.
Great offensive rebounding there by Payson as Swayze is able to come back down with the ball and force the foul.
It looks like we have Cornell coming in, Cornell coming in for Robbins, and Byes coming out with Wolf, I believe, coming in.
That is correct, as Cornell now trying to find someone open. Tight defense here.
Passes deep back to Wolf.
And Jordan has played great inbound defense. Payson taking a while
to find.
Wolf
drives in, unable to do it. Cornell makes the rebound. Another foul on Jordan.
And Payson has been killing it so far on the offensive glass this possession. That is, I believe, their fourth opportunity here. And Cornell will get a chance here to tie and take the lead at the line.
Cornell takes the first shot. He makes it.
All tied up here.
Number two, Green, coming out with number 20, Thompson coming in for him. Or, sorry, 22, Dean.
Cornell now a chance to take the lead for Payson.
There it is. There's the lead for Payson yet again.
As Taylor now.
2-3, Gagner makes the two.
Good defense. But Jordan has just been able to score no matter how tight the defense has been.
Each team really just trading off points, just taking that one-point lead as many times as they can. And as you see right there, Wolf giving Payson that one-point lead again.
Yeah, first quarter was very defensive. Now we've moved to offense, and it's been a very fun game to watch so far. Both teams very even so far.
Very interesting game as well.
Taylor does not like the call, and he felt he was straight up. Trying to plead his case to the officials, but number 33, Camden, will go to the line.
There's that first shot. He makes it, tying up the game.
So Robbins, after a quick break, will check back in for Swayze. Swayze's been providing valuable minutes. I'd probably say they're sixth man off the bench.
And there's the lead yet again for Jordan by one.
Isaac Wolf now will bring it down for the Lions.
Wolf trying to drive in, passes to Cornell.
DeGraw for three.
Makes it. 2-point lead. That's the first 2-point lead you've seen in a while during this quarter.
Robbins, tight defense here. He's got a couple of steals here and a couple of blocks, so tight defense and an all-around great game so far by Robbins.
Robbins really putting pressure on them. and it's thrown out.
Poked away there by Robbins, and it will stay with Jordan as we approach 4 minutes left in this first half.
Number 12, Vandenberg throwing in for Jordan.
And number 33, Camden, has been going off tonight.
And that ties up the game yet again with Wolf now trying to drive in.
Wolf, step back, jumper, no good.
Taylor, though, able to get the rebound and make the two.
Taylor with the pullback shot there. And if I'm Jordan, I'm looking in number 33, Camden's direction.
I mean, Camden's been doing absolutely amazing so far. And there's the pass to number 10. Number 22 drives to drive in. Number 31, Sullivan makes the shot with a foul on Payson.
Now the line is number 31, Landon Sullivan. Bides checking back in for the Lions here.
With, looks like DeGraw coming out.
No shot. Lane violation there on Jordan.
I mean, I feel like everyone, though, kind of left a little bit early on that shot, but I think it was Jordan that left first, and 24.
Bennett will check in for Taylor.
Robbins passes into Byes.
As we have a tied ball game here in Payson.
Byes tries to drive in.
Wolf floater, no good.
Bennett tries to get the rebound, but just is unable to.
As Robbins now guarding Staley.
Passes over to 12, Vandenberg.
Three is up. And goes. Jordan has the largest, their largest lead of the night.
Buys with the three. Unable to make it.
Offensive foul there on Bennett. And it looks like Taylor will check back in.
It's a timeout.
So Jordan, who was a big underdog coming in tonight, now holds a three-point lead. What do you think Payson has to do to kind of pull away and tie this game up?
I think Payson really just needs to be guarding 33 Camden Gagnier, as he has been making most of Jordan's shots tonight, and they really just need to be putting a lot of pressure on him, put Robbins on him. Robbins is an amazing defender, and I think that their talent would be equally matched if they were up against each other.
Yeah, and Payson really hasn't been able to do much on offense, you know. They have been able to get offensive boards, but Jordan now playing much tighter defense. We'll see what adjustments they made here in that quick timeout as Taylor checked back in right before, so he's out there.
Number 10 is Staley.
Nearly stolen by Byes, but good job by Jordan.
Cornell doing a really nice job blocking 31.
And this is the tight defense Payson needs. As a carry is called, and Payson forces the turnover, and that's what Payson needed coming out of the timeout.
Staley not the happiest with that call, but I think it was the right call, honestly.
Yeah, definitely carried there as Byes now trying to drive in. Payson's been great so far, passing it on the perimeter, trying to drive in all game long, but not finding much.
There's Robbins with the two, only puts them down by one now.
Good step back jumper there. Robbins able to create space and get open. And Payson gets a much needed bucket.
Number 12 out now, Vandenberg driving over to 22.
There's another tight defensive possession. His step back jumper is good.
And there's Gnier again making the two.
He has been making almost all of their points.
Wolf goes for the three. Just a little bit short.
Cornell is able to control it and find Robbins.
And Taylor goes for the two. It bounces off the rim. Little low there.
And Staley will bring it down, trying to slow it down here as Jordan has a three-point lead.
Foul on Taylor with the shove.
Swayze's now checking in here.
Looks like Taylor's coming out.
Taylor with two personal fouls here as we approach halftime, just a minute left. Jordan holding on to a three-point lead. Tight defense there as...
We have a player down, or tried to get the refs to think he was down.
No good there by Byes. Byes' three-point shooting has not been his strength as Robbins off the front of the rim there.
Number 10, Staley driving down now with getting double-teamed by Byes and Robbins. Cornell with a block.
That sends Camden to the line to shoot two once again. Chance to put Jordan up five. You know, this is what I love about the playoffs. You know, on paper, this matchup should not be this close, but Jordan putting up a good fight here and now leading it by four.
And they're not wanting to give up any points whatsoever. And they're not. I mean, it's a very close match, as you said, and both of them really just giving up. And there's the biggest lead I think that Jordan's had all night, with five.
Payson once led by seven early in the first quarter. Now trail by five.
Robbins passes over to Swayze.
Swayze hits the deck, wants the foul. He's not going to get it. As there's 40 seconds left here in this first half.
Byes really trying to put a lot of pressure on number four. He was able to do so.
Not allowing any room. As I think he was a little surprised there to get that open. And had a little bit of lane, but now Byes right back in front of him.
Byes putting a lot of pressure on him and kicks the ball out.
That is a backcourt violation there, so Payson will get the ball back with 14 seconds.
Payson, see if they can maybe just get a three or two in there just to close that gap. I don't think they're going to be able to tie the game up by the time this half finishes, but at least be able to close that gap somewhat.
If you're Payson, go for the last shot here. You go into halftime with a little bit of momentum as Byes
drives in, but gets swatted. 22 does not make the get the ball off in time.
So Jordan has the lead against number three Payson, 35-30 as we go into halftime. We'll be back after the half.
All right, Payson, and we're not going to throw down to our sideline report, Jared Johnson. Jared, what have you been seeing so far in that first half?
They just need to play a little bit better defense. I've seen Jordan playing great defense on Payson. They've been really denying the ball from Payson, and I think Payson needs to get in a better groove, and they just need to start making buckets. It can't just be Zach, and it can't just be Isaac. Yeah, Payson's been playing great offense, and Payson needs to play better defense in order to beat this team. Right now, they're only up by 5, and Zach with great effort. So Jordan just needs to, they just need to stop Jordan from playing great defense.
So Jared, what do you think we should be doing with this? What do you think Payson needs to do to get the lead again?
Payson just needs to make those open buckets, you know, and Jordan's just playing excellent defense, so it's kind of hard for Payson to make those buckets, but at the same time, they got to sink those buckets. It can't just be Zach, and like I said, it can't just be Isaac, and it's impossible to just have two or three players playing, and Jordan's playing good defense.
I absolutely agree with you.
I think Payson just need to calm down and get in a groove. And I mean, right now they're down by 5, but they could be up by like 20 right now. And I think they haven't fallen into that groove yet. And I think that they can do it as long as they calm down and start sinking their shots. And even though Jordan's playing great defense, Payson's got to start playing defense too. They haven't been playing well defense. They need to start playing that half-court defense that has worked really well for them in the season. And I think if they start doing that, then who knows, maybe we'll win this game.
I definitely agree with you, and I'm going to actually let you go now as we're starting to wrap up this halftime. Thank you for that insight.
Welcome back here as we are approaching the start of the second half here. Preston, you know, talking to Jared, Payson finds themselves down 5. They've been in these close games before. What do you think they need to do to come out once again on top?
Definitely think they need to work, especially on their defense. I've seen them try the full court press several times, and it's worked out really well for them. I'm surprised they haven't tried it yet. And as I've seen from several games, Payson is good from coming from behind in this second half. So it should be interesting to see how the second half goes, especially with Jordan up by 5 right now.
Yeah, Payson has not been able to stop Jordan at all. You know, number 33 getting his will done and really boxing out a big problem.
Absolutely. As we start this half, number 4 passes over to number 2, Green, who takes the shot. Just misses it and buys with the rebound.
Good stop there for Payson to start off the half, and that's what they needed. Is Green, who comes in today, Jordan's leading scorer. That one is blocked. Taylor able to grab the board.
And hits the two. Looks like number 33, Denier, hurt his hand somehow. Kind of tried to shake it off a bit, but.
Great offensive possession here so far for Payson. Able to get in, get the offensive board, score two, and a chance to make this a three-point play.
And Taylor for another, for that extra point right here.
No good. And Jordan comes away with the rebound.
Say coming down number four now.
Jordan able to hold on to this three-point lead.
Passing really well just outside of the arc.
Someone's corralled in by number four. Great ball movement here so far by Jordan. His three is up.
And it's good. 31, Sullivan makes that shot.
And now a six-point lead for Jordan, their largest of the night.
Robbins goes for the three, just misses it. Hands it, Payson gets the rebound now.
Payson's been great so far with the second chance opportunities as Wolf misses that one, and Payson cannot shoot so far tonight. Wide open for three is Green.
Green makes the shot. It's the biggest lead we've seen of the night for either team.
9-point lead for Jordan. And Payson not been able to shoot well tonight at all. Taylor puts it back.
Trying to close that gap that Jordan set, but Jordan trying to just keep that lead and even extend that lead.
Jordan has been able to control the tempo of the game so far, and that's really been what's key here.
Absolutely. Controlling that tempo, and you get to say what happens in the game is ideal, especially when you're not the home team and you get to control that court. It is a very powerful thing.
And they've really silenced this student section here big tonight, but not been a big factor.
Off the shoe of Spencer DeGraw.
Still Jordan basketball as they lead by seven here. Jordan continuing to just pass the ball and find whoever they want open, really. As Green now tries to drive in.
Goes for the two, but is not able to make it with Wolf getting the rebound.
Payson needs points.
Gives it to DeGraw, who takes the three, makes it.
And that gets the crowd back involved. Payson now down four. Got to get back here on defense, though.
Jordan really moving the ball, and there's the three up by Green, and he makes it.
And you got to guard him. He's their leading scorer. He comes in averaging 16 to 9.
Taylor able to make that easy layup, though, with a two.
Got to get back on defense here, as that one is airballed, and the rebound goes to Robbins.
Dias tries to drive in.
Is fouled before the shot. Payson's down five in what's been a surprising game so far. Not expecting what I was expecting coming into tonight.
Absolutely, but Jordan absolutely giving Payson a run for their money, not letting them get any, giving any points up, and having the biggest lead of the night so far, and has really been able to hold that lead since the second quarter.
And Payson not shooting well tonight at all as Taylor's foul. There it is.
He makes the two.
So he will get two shots here with a chance to put Payson within three. And Payson so far this half needs to get down on defense as Taylor misses the first one.
Just a little short there.
Payson so far has been able to score more this half, but however, is allowing Jordan to score right back with them.
As we said at the beginning of the, right before this game, they need to stop those three-pointers. Those three-pointers are always their downfall.
And Taylor makes the second one, so it is now a four-point game.
Green. For now, really good job with the defense there.
Looks like they're going to call a foul on Payson, Isaac Wolf there. Better job there boxing out, but yeah, still got the foul.
Sullivan passing in the four.
That one tipped. Still controlled, though, by Jordan.
Robbins tries to make the block, was unable to with number 10, Staley making the shot.
Tight defense there, just better shot as that one is poked away, and Jordan's got another turnover. Three is up. Short.
Oh, good.
And that one is off Payson and will stay with Jordan.
Number four throwing in for Jordan. Number two, Green. Robbins will swats it away and Byes takes it.
Taylor there with the swat.
Robbins to Taylor. There's the two. Again, a 4-point lead by Taylor, trying to close that gap yet again.
Nearly a travel there by Robbins. Luckily able to find Taylor, who made the layup. Taylor has been having a great game tonight inside the paint.
Absolutely, and Taylor, I believe, one of the tallest players on Payson's team, and is a senior, has been doing really well this season.
Their leading scorer here tonight as Payson's down four.
Wolf takes the three, and he makes it, closing the gap to just, I believe, 1 point.
Payson's done great so far, and they've been able to box out, something that they weren't able to do, as and stolen.
Robbins are able to pass to Taylor, who just misses the shot.
Able to draw the foul, though, and great job by Robbins, able to save that and find Taylor.
It's a beautiful pass there, knowing where your teammate was and trusting them to get the ball and not a moment of hesitation passing it to Taylor.
A chance to tie here and take the lead for the first time this half.
And there it is. There's the that is the first tie game of this quarter and of this third quarter, and Payson, they're close to their being to taking a lead.
Taylor, the leading scorer so far tonight, has been big for them so far.
And there it is, Payson with their first lead.
And when your star players are having an off night, you need players like Taylor Setball up. As he goes to the bench.
With Swayze coming in for him, and then 22, Dean coming in for Sullivan, 31.
Stolen there and great defense.
Passes over to Swayze, who just waits for those two to go straight over and makes the two. Puts Payson up by three.
And what you saw there was the full court press that has worked so well for Payson. I'm really surprised they didn't turn to it earlier.
And I totally agree that full-court press has always worked for them. But as I also said, Payson is good from coming from behind in this second half.
And that's an offensive foul. Jordan Bench does not like the call. Payson
very happy with that call.
That is five fouls for Jordan here.
That's a timeout, though, for Jordan. Matt, what have you noticed about this for the second half, especially with Jordan?
Jordan, the first half, controlled the tempo, right? And early into the third, they controlled the tempo. It looked like at the beginning, Payson forgot about Will Green, their leading scorer, and really just forgot to box out. Payson now storming back. We're down nine now, lead by three. Payson's got to continue to play tight defense, force steals, and make shots on the other end.
And Jordan needs to, really stop giving up those steals by Payson. That's really what Payson's been getting the ball the most, is they've been able to pick it off of them during their passes, and Jordan's not even able to get a shot off.
Jordan needs to go to their players and try to get the threes. Like we said earlier, the threes have been the downfall of Payson. Payson not being able to guard the threes well. Nearly lost to Uinta. However, able to pull that one off. And Byes,
White ball.
Swayze called there for the foul.
Sorry, not white ball.
Jordan ball.
Jordan ball.
Green.
Green passing into Magassa.
It's not quite a full court press, but definitely tight D here by Cornell.
Cornell doing a very nice job with that defense. And there it is, Swayze passes over to Cornell, who slips.
And that's going to be a travel there. Great steal by Swayze. Great find to Cornell, just slipped there on the court. And
nothing you can really control there, but just have to really walk that off and don't let that get to your head as they try to block Jordan as they come down this court, and Pace is now defense.
Unfortunate there for the Lions, but Jordan giving a break there as what would have been an easy fast break.
Cornell again though with the very good defense. And Wolf almost takes the ball from Green, but Green airballs it with 33, picking up the rebound and making that shot.
And there was absolutely no boxing out as Robbins
goes for the three, and it rolls out.
Green comes in and takes that rebound. And a chance here to take
with
the
Byes.
Lead. Green is fouled, and we'll go to the line to shoot two. That foul on Swayze.
The first foul on Byes.
Looks like that one was on Byes. I thought it was going to be on Swayze, but
I thought it was two, but Green now going for that shot.
This one to tie the game.
He makes it.
And a chance to give Jordan back the lead.
And hits the front of the rim, though, way low.
And Swayze was able to control the rebound. Great job boxing out there by Payson.
Wolf now trying to drive in. Hits the layup, puts them up by two.
With three guys on him, that was a great shot there by Wolf.
Took his time with that shot and kind of let them run over him and so for him to take that shot.
Foul before the shot on Byes. Byes does not like the call.
Neither does the Payson bench, it looks like. None of the coaches that happy with it.
We're going to call White 34, so that's Josh Cornell with the foul.
I didn't see the hold there, but
a little too tight there by defense. Is
Robbins, though, able to block it and passes over to Byes. Gives it to Swayze.
Jordan Bench wants a travel as Payson. Swayze thought about that one.
Falls and loses the ball with Gunnier taking it. Wolf, Byes, and Robbins all going after the ball.
And a foul there by Cornell, and that's going to be his fourth personal foul. We're going to see who they put in. I think it's time to put back in Bridger Taylor.
Absolutely, but honestly, I do think that was the right play by Cornell, trying to get that ball. I mean, you could see that every single Payson player was diving after that ball, and Jordan was barely able to hang on to it. They got lucky with that foul there, honestly.
And Taylor will check back in.
There it is, Cornell coming out, but Jordan coming in.
Jordan now able to find Green.
33, able to make that shot, ties the game up.
And he has been able to make it from anywhere tonight. Having a great game tonight.
Robbins looking for an opening, passes to Byes.
42 seconds left here, all tied up.
And then as Swayze makes the two, puts them up by two again.
Swayze's got 4 points here this quarter.
Very nice defense. Looks like Swayze's gonna be guarding number four.
And looks like Jordan might try to take the last shot. No. Foul before? Is it before the shot?
I believe it was before the shot.
No, it was not. So it looks like number four. Or
Byes, their third personal foul. But all three fouls in this quarter. So Byes really needs to stop fouling as
we do not want him to foul. His team does not want him to foul out. This is a key player in their defense right now.
Jordan now in the 1-1 for the rest of the half, and that will hurt Payson as Bice goes to the bench with three fouls.
McGraw comes in for him. And there's the tie game right now. And I believe Payson's going to try and get that last shot with only 13 seconds left of this quarter.
Will be interesting to see who they have take that shot as DeGraw has it. Over to Taylor.
Swayze goes for the three. Barely bounces off.
So Payson tied with Jordan. So we saw a very good third quarter from both teams. What do you think Jordan did well during that third quarter, Preston?
Jordan, I mean, did start off real poorly, but kind of struggling to find the rhythm. But I feel like as soon as they kind of started getting their ball to 33, Gneer, they're one of their best shooters this game. They're able to get those shots in, and it's able to get into Payson's head.
And when Payson went on the run, you know, Jordan got up 9, and, you know, Taylor was able to bring him back. I think it's important that Taylor is able to play this fourth quarter and get Payson a lead, because he has been their leading scorer here tonight.
I agree. And Payson really need to, as we've said all night, tie it up their defense. Go for the full court press. It's worked for them before, and I'm surprised that they haven't done it yet, especially since they've used it in the first and second quarters before, and all the way in the fourth and still haven't seen it. It's like they're not being aggressive enough with that defense.
And Payson's failing to box out here, especially on the defensive side. Jordan getting a lot of second chance opportunities, resulting in easy buckets.
Taylor, though, not coming in. Looks like it is DeGraw, Robbins, Swayze, Wolf, and Bennett for Payson in.
A little bit of a shorter lineup here for Payson.
But still a very strong lineup, very strong players that from what we've seen. And there's the two, putting them at the lead.
DeGraw there, good shot, and we'll see if it's kind of more back and forth like we saw early in the second quarter.
McGraw, I wouldn't say is one of the most aggressive players, but definitely is one of the most consistent players, making a lot of shots and a lot of really good blocks, and has very good awareness of the court.
Swayze played tight D here. He's called for the foul. So that's 18 fouls for Payson. That's 2 on Swayze. Payson in foul trouble.
Payson needing to be careful with those fouls. Like, picking up a lot of fouls very quickly in the last 4 minutes of this game.
You got key guys like Cordell, Swayze, and Taylor all on the bench right now with foul trouble. Those are guys Payson would love to have out here on the court.
Absolutely. And Green makes the first shot. Now Jordan only down by 1 point. And he makes that second shot, tying up the game yet again.
Wolf will take it down for the Lions and looking to give Payson the lead once again.
Jordan just really trying to protect the arc. Not really worrying about outside of the arc, it looks like. Thinking that Payson won't try to go for those threes, but it is working well. Payson not able to drive into to that arc.
Tight defense there on Robbins as he was unable to get the ball back to DeGraw, kind of trapped him there that quarter.
And Robbins is a good three-pointer shooter, so they're really playing smart defense right now. Bounces out.
And a good offensive ward there is Wolf with an uncharacteristic miss.
There's Swayze, gets swatted, and that is a foul drawn.
Great job there by Swayze, able to pick up the foul there. So he will go to the line to shoot two.
Opportunity to give Payson that 2-point lead yet again.
Misses the first one. He will get another shot.
Swayze for that second shot now.
Makes that one, and Payson with a 1-point lead.
Bies coming in now for Swayze. Payson full court press now, it looks like, is what Bies is telling him, full court.
And this is something we've waited to see all game long.
The super aggressive defense by Payson, something that works very well for them. And it's going to definitely drain on Jordan as they come in the last 6.5 minutes of this game.
And surprised we didn't see it earlier, you know, especially when Jordan went on a very good run there to take the lead. On a foul, and it looks like that one's going to be on Robbins.
Didn't see the foul there, but you're going
to... Nope, that one's on Bennett. That's 4 for Bennett.
Bennett now kind of starting to look like he's in foul trouble.
Ties the game up, and now a chance to take the lead as Bennett will go to the bench. Swayze checking back in. A chance to give Jordan the lead. As Nagasaw makes both, so Jordan with the 1-point lead.
Robbins now with the ball.
Robbins has been quiet tonight, but definitely still made his presence felt early in the game.
Doing really well with defense. I feel like a little dark in offense, but there's Bides at the three. Bounces out.
As Swayze there is called for the foul, and he now, I believe, has 3. And no, that's his 4th. Or no, sorry, 3rd.
Number 4 on the line again. I guess I feel like he's been on the line a lot, and Payson does not want to put him on there. He's been automatic from the line. But there's the miss that you don't really expect to see from a shooter like this.
And now a chance to put Jordan up 2.
There's that 2.
That time he makes it. So Wolf quickly down the court now for Payson. They call a timeout. Payson down to Preston. What do you think Payson needs to do to pull away here in these final minutes?
Payson, I feel like, just needs to stop getting those really stupid fouls. I mean, those are fouls that they can easily avoid, but they keep picking them up, and he's been giving Jordan those opportunities for those threes. Just that is how Jordan's been able to keep up with them in this last quarter, especially with Payson still having the momentum for it and trying that full court press, but it was working out for them. They're just unable to stop them when they're on the paint in the box.
And I agree. I think if you're Jordan, continue to attack inside. You're drawing fouls. Get the ball to guys like Green and number 33 Camden, who have really been your leading scorers all night.
Absolutely. So a very close game, though, with Jordan only leading by 2 points with a little under 6 minutes left of this fourth quarter. So anyone's game right now. Finish with a timeout.
So
looks like Wolf will be throwing in for Payson.
Mitchell seems to be talking to the officials here, not sure what about. Seems like they got it all sorted out, though.
There's Wolf passes into Byes.
Yet to see Taylor check back into the game.
Which has been very surprising. And Robbins with the 3 makes it, gives Payson a 1-point lead.
And Robbins is your guy you've been going to all year long. Feed him the ball right now.
If Robbins just usually scoring about half the points for Payson. Like it is, he is definitely the person you want to be passing the ball to. And expecting, kind of surprised to see him go a little cold tonight.
But Taylor's really stepped up in his place, and really surprised we haven't seen him.
Wonder if Coach Mitchell's trying to save him for that last couple of minutes to really just drive in and bring it home.
He is in foul trouble. As 3 is up.
Bounces out. It is out on Jordan.
Stays with the Lions. I'm really surprised we haven't seen Taylor in. You know, it is the playoffs, you know. It is win or go home at this point.
Absolutely, and Robbins goes for the three, makes the three, puts Payson up by two.
He is heating up right now when it matters. Just under 5 minutes.
Robbins willing to take the baton and bring it home right now in those last 4.5 minutes, but again, still anyone's game with only a 2-point lead for Payson.
Robbins, one of the starters last year on it, what was a disappointing second round exit. And Jordan calls a timeout. And great game so far. And this is why you love playoff basketball. Two teams that during the regular season had two completely different seasons, now battling here in the playoffs.
They know exactly what this game means. It's either this is their last game for the entire season or they keep going. And I think, and as far as I'm aware, we've only had a 2-point lead from either team as the biggest lead for this entire quarter. Both teams keep each other very, very close.
Yes, and agreeing. Both of these teams have a few seniors on the team who do not want this to be their last game.
And absolutely.
Guys like Nagisa for Jordan as well as Camden, both seniors having great games. Will Green also.
Then Bridger Taylor and Zachary Robbins, both seniors for Payson, have been doing very well. And they do not want to end on a loss, especially with how they've been doing so far this year.
Exactly. What a disappointing end it would be for Payson should they lose this game. And really surprised to see Taylor still on the bench.
And it looks like we have Byes and Swayze, as well as Robbins, Wolf, and DeGraw out for Payson.
And Jordan will have the ball.
Bounces off the toe of number four, but is able to keep the ball.
They're gonna call the foul there, and Green will go to the line.
Coach Mitchell, not happy, thought he saw a foul, but just so upset right now. He's kind of making fun of the refs, it looks like.
Gotta be careful not to get a technical foul here, as this crowd is loud.
And he goes low.
Off the front of the rim is, they got a box out here. Cannot give Jordan another chance at a shot here.
Payson crowd really trying to throw Green off of his game, but unable to do it for that second shot. Well, Payson only up by one.
Payson with a chance to take the largest lead of this quarter. As Wazy now.
Back to Byes and then over to Wolf.
As Robbins passing it around, Wolf for three.
Rolls out, but Swayze's able to make the rebound. Gives it to DeGraw, who goes for the three. He makes it, nothing but net.
Payson loves it. Payson now leads by four.
The biggest lead we've seen in this quarter. And Payson with a very strong defense right now, it looks like. And almost a double team.
Tipped away there. And Nadia saw. Just trying to control it there. Finds Green. As Payson not allowing anyone open. A lot better defense than we saw in the first half. And I think best defense we've seen all night.
I agree. They're really trying to not let Jordan get to catch up with them, especially with these 4 points that they have right now. Only 3 minutes left. They want to keep that lead and just hope that they can keep that lead and just bring it home, especially when they're at home.
Green missed that last three to give Payson the ball. Payson's done a lot better job at rebounding this fourth quarter, and it is shown here on the scoreboard.
Byes tries to drive in, passes over to DeGraw, who takes the three. Bounces out, but Robbins is able to pick up the rebound and make the two.
That was fantastic ball movement.
Playbook move right there. And it's out on Jordan. Jordan started choking the last 3 minutes of this game.
Payson crowd is loving it. 2 minutes and 23 seconds left, and Payson up sixth. Best basketball, I think, for Payson played all night.
this is definitely a change of pace from the first half, where Jordan had silenced the Payson fans. They weren't really saying all that much. Now Payson letting them know that where they are, Jordan is on enemy ground, and Jordan is the enemy here, and they're going to let them know that.
As Jordan playing tight defense here, not allowing anyone open.
Green, though, also doing a really nice job blocking byes.
As Swayze tries to cut in, passes back out to DeGraw.
DeGraw, really strong player. We're getting double teamed.
Lots of double teams here in this last couple of minutes, and really this last possession, and great job so far.
Wolf passes to Baez with Green blocking him with the reach-in violation.
And I believe Baez should go to the line for a one-on-one opportunity here.
We're facing an even bigger lead.
Jordan has played a great game tonight so far, and Baez with a chance to extend their lead.
Payson doing what they do best, coming from behind in the second half.
Baez misses that one, and Jordan has a chance to put it within one score here.
Green coming down.
No shot. However, number 22, Kent Dean, who the 6'3" senior shooting guard, will go to the line to shoot two here.
He's facing at 10 fouls, Dean making that first shot with now only Payson, Payson only up by 5 now.
And a chance to cut the deficit to 4.
Then Green coming out with Vandenberg coming in for him. Balances in.
Great free throws there, and now a full court press from Jordan. Payson's got to get the ball, and Wolf is fouled, so he will go to the line for a one-on-one opportunity here. These are very important free throws for Payson. Payson's got to make these.
Green coming back in for Vanderbeek. I'm kind of confused there. Vanderbeek just came in for Green, but kind of just switching out there. I wonder if they're just trying to not let Green get any stupid fouls.
Yeah, Green in foul trouble, and definitely a player you want with the ball here in these late moments. It's Zach.
Robbins makes the first three. Missed him up by 5 yet again.
Baez instructing these guys to play hand up. Only one guy.
And Robbins nothing but net, putting him up by 6 now.
Payson's got to be careful not to foul here while also guarding the perimeter.
There's Green with the 3. Nothing but net.
As Green, amazing step back 3 there.
Still anyone's game.
To put Jordan within a possession with 1 minute left.
Definitely not what we would expect to see, especially from the last 2 minutes where Payson was up by 7-8 points, and now again they're only up by 3 with Jordan really close to him with a minute left.
Give Jordan credit. They have fought back. They were down 9 at one point in the first quarter. Now only 12 by 3, they were up.
Not going down without a fight. And they're making it known that they will not be going down without that fight.
Payson will get the ball after this timeout. And Green, great 3 there as we went into halftime. And I think if you're Payson, you got to be careful. You don't want to foul, but you also don't want to allow those guys to get open from 3 because they can shoot.
And with how close this game is, I would honestly say start throwing in seniors, as they've done really well. Throw in Taylor, throw in, you know, keep DeGraw in, keep Robbins in, keep them in there, because this might be their last game from this score, but also they do very well with it. They communicate with each other very well.
Taylor's still on the bench. He might have fouled out there. I don't know why Taylor's not in right now, as Jordan with the full court press able to find Robbins.
Dr. Swayze over to Robbins yet again.
They gotta get past the half court line.
And stolen by number 4.
And
Jordan opportunity to tie the game.
With a 3 here, and this would be big.
Very nice defense though by Payson.
Payson's got to be able to close out here on defense as Jordan calls the timeout. And the full court press here for Jordan working very well, forcing Robbins to throw that turnover. And with 41 seconds, it is a one possession game, and Jordan has the ball.
Absolutely. And I mean, Jordan kind of taking the playbook of Payson, where Payson had started that full court. And now Jordan trying that too. Both teams trying the most trying to be as aggressive as possible. Not wanting to foul, but absolutely wants to get these shots in. It's such a close game right now that both teams kind of worried right now. Looking at the benches while they're playing, each bench kind of silent, trying to just see if they can do anything to let their teammates know how they can win this game.
And if you're Payson, you cannot foul. If they can, at most, if you don't foul, they can tie the game and you can go down and with a chance to take the lead and potentially win the game. If you foul, they could potentially take the lead here.
Absolutely.
If you're Payson, you gotta play good defense without fouling.
They need to also play legal defense because they've been getting a lot of fouls. Here we go. The same five from Payson that we've seen almost this entire quarter with Bies, Swayze, Robbins, DeGron, Wolf. Number four, Nagasin throwing in the ball for Jordan.
Tight defense here by the Lions.
Passes over. DeGron almost steals the ball. But Jordan able to keep on.
Bies playing tight defense here.
Robbins also able to
away.
Almost take the ball. But they miss.
Able to get the board.
They go for the three.
And
they make it. And they get it.
Almost went out of bounds. But Jordan has the ball again. And he
travels. Payson so happy with that call.
20 seconds left. Payson has got to be able to get this ball in.
If that was Payson, honestly, I would just hold the ball, not let Jordan get the ball.
Get the ball. Jordan is going to probably immediately foul Robbins to pass it in here.
Absolutely. And looks like there's Wolf right now.
You got to get past half court here.
And there's the foul.
Wolf with the chance to put the game away.
Wolf makes this shot, almost guarantees Payson with the win.
Payson not putting any guys in the key there.
Keeping everyone in the back as they've done several times when these games are close, just not letting them get those points. And Wolf doesn't make it.
Huge break for Jordan.
Bies trying to drive through. Super aggressive defense by Payson.
Final seconds of the game.
Mitchell trying to come in.
He didn't get a shot off.
And there it is. Payson wins the game.
Tight defense there, Jordan, absolutely heartbroken.
Jordan just on the court, not even moving, not happy with it. As Jordan, I would be happy with that game still. They played a very good game.
Jordan's season comes to an end. And I think the most surprising thing was how great Payson's defense was. Jordan wasn't able to get a shot off in regulation.
No. In that last 30 seconds, no points were scored, and it was really just each team having just such tight defense.
Payson will move on to the second round. It will be here Friday night. Preston, what do you think Payson has to do to be victorious on Friday?
Honestly, I would say kind of bring the energy that they had for that second half into the first half, because they always kind of start to come from the back in that second half, but they are always usually able to come in from there. And usually try, and I would say avoid the fouls, but other than that, Payson, I feel like, does have a chance for Friday to continue moving through these this bracket.
Congratulations to both teams tonight, and Jordan on a great season. We'll be back on Friday.
We're signing off for now. I'm Preston Carr.
I'm Matt Watkins.
All right.